Hello everyone, myself Uday Datrak. I am planning to teach 100 plus web application security test cases. This is my channel. Yes, I will be uploading daily one lesson, like we have around 100 plus lessons now. So subscribe to my channel guys, you will be getting alert for everyday video uploads. Now as you have searched like PHP simple web login GitHub, and so far we have set around 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 applications. Now we'll try to set up the 6th application. And in the next 2 lessons, we'll be using another 2 websites and we'll stop it. Now, after that, we'll be having around 100 plus web applications to test locally. And in each web application, we are trying to learn something new. Now let's see this application. Yep, one more thing guys, please inform your friends who are into cyber security so that they can also learn and they can work with you, share your knowledge and grow together. Like sharing improves your knowledge a lot, so share it with your friends guys. So I'm ready to help you as much as I can. Whenever you come across any question, comment there, I'll be answering within just 24 hours. As soon as we open, we need to read, we first need to see like PHP login, okay, 100% PHP login, the visual frameworks. He has given some instructions, that's very good, how to use it, then this will be very easier. Open config.php with the text editor and find the variables, change the username password, okay. Note that you have to use the salted version of your password, okay. I'm just copying these all files. BAM64. I paste all these files here. Now what happens guys, we need to see whether the VAMP is running. Yes, now if you try to browse this lesson 8 folder, then it automatically loads index.php file. Let's see that. Because that's the default file which always loads. Okay, this is looking very nice, but this application doesn't have the registration page as you can see here. What he's saying, the system is 100% coded in PHP. Okay, login.php. okay, download the source code, open config.php. okay, we don't need any editor for that. Thought it's a username password. Oh no, yeah guys, open config.php with the favorite editor and find the username password, change the username password. Wow, so here this particular application doesn't even using any database here. So now the very important learning is there are some applications which can't even use database, that like hardly, like we can come across only 1% of the application where they hardcode the username and password. This is also one critical security issue which we'll discuss in the later stages. Now we'll focus on the step. Now what is saying is change the username. Note that you have to use the salted version of your password. Okay, now I'll copy this. This is the password is hashed here. Okay. Hash analyzer. Now let's see the default password. Can we guess like what it could be? Let's try with the password also, Steve. Maybe he used the same name. No, incorrect information. Okay, let's try to guess password as password. Now, leave it, guys. Now we go to hash analyzer. We'll try to analyze. We'll try to know what type of algorithm they are using. Okay, bcrypt. Okay, hash and salt. Decode something like, now we know that they are using some algorithm called bcrypt, or else we'll also search decode hash. Decode hash online crack station where they are using MD5, various types of hashes. But here I cannot see anything like a particular hash called bcrypt, but still we'll try once. Unknown. The result is unknown here. We'll try to see in another website. You should not restrict yourself to one website. This is also one way of security testing, guys. Now I'm covering, but I'll cover in detail later. We'll do the light touch so that you can understand. Show plain text and solves. Captcha. Run BMP SK8. No. So it's not working. Now we'll try to generate the hash for this. Generate bcrypt hash online. If it doesn't work, we'll try one more time. Don't know what, why rounds are 12. String to encrypt. I'll use the password as password. Hash it. Okay. Looks like we have got some other error, like on line number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, everything looks good, but undefined variable. Hey, he did not complete the code. Whether he did not complete or did I mess up? Okay, the PHP should end with this piece of code. I will go back. Find variable in line number 5. Big A, everything in double quotes itself. Username Steve, password. Oh, it's taking as dollar as, one second. Maybe I'll go back to the old code which we had here. Let me open the code which we downloaded and let me see. Yeah, we can also see it here directly in the config.php file. It doesn't have, no. This is working fine. Password. Okay, let me hold on a minute and try to see. If I get panic, I may not do properly. Yeah, very easy, guys. I found it within a minute. The thing is that I tried to use the first website, it generated the wrong hash. Then I went to the second website and entered the password as password, and I clicked on bcrypt. I got some hash. And I pasted here. Came back. We need to save that file, Control S, and password as password. And we are successfully logged in. That's easy. But this application is looking good because we also have some more pages like about and some contact page here. Status logged in, PHP by Mario found. Okay, now we have successfully set up this application, guys. We still have 5 minutes of time, I believe. Like we did it very quickly. When you write, always remember, like when you enter this username password, what happens within the login.php, this will be passed in the backend, and where will be stored this username when we enter. In order to see that, right click, view source, input name is equal to username. When you enter the username, it will be stored inside the name called username. When you enter the password will be stored in the this particular variable. And to which page they will send the password? If you see, we have one more important learning, guys. Action equal to double quotes means the username password will be sent in the backend to same page, login.php itself. If you give some other name like hello.php, then this username password will be sent to hello.php. So now, if you open this particular login.php file, you will see something in the backend code which is accepting the username password too. Like, see, now post submit, they are accepting our username here. Our username, whatever we submitted, will be accepted using this function, and the password will be accepted using this function. And in the backend, there is some checking is happening whether the username password is correct or not, and then that's a different story. Now we understand the basic concepts now. That's it, guys.